Hello everyone, this is Vikas from Talentown magazine. Today we have a very special guest with us, somebody you have seen almost everywhere, in fashion shows, in music videos, in movies, and also on the streets running marathons. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the one and only and 100% made in India, Milind Soman. Hi Milind, how are you?
Hi, thank you very much. All very, very well.
Thank you for joining us. Milind, let me start by saying that it has been more than 25 years, but still, whenever I picture you appearing on a screen, I imagine you popping out of a box shirtless. Well, this is how you were introduced to the world in the Made in India video, and rest, as they say, is history. You have come a long way since then. How do you look back at the journey so far?
It's been a lot of fun. I'm happy that I took up my first job as a model, and that was in 1989. And I'm saying I'm happy because at that time I didn't even know that modeling was a profession. I was studying to be an engineer, and you know, sometimes we feel that, you know, this is something new. I don't know anything about it. Should I do it? Shouldn't I do it? But I'm glad I started. With the first job that I got in 1989, because it took me all over the world. It introduced me to lots of amazing people. It opened up so many opportunities, and is still doing that after more than 30 years, in fact. Mm-hmm. So it's been a great journey. It's been fantastic. Absolutely.
Great. Milind, so you have a new web series coming up by the name Paurushpur. The title itself sounds very masculine. So what is this place, Paurushpur, and what all happens there?
So Paurushpur is a kingdom. We don't know where it is. We don't know when it exists. Obviously, many hundreds of years ago, that is the kind of environment that is created. And what we focus on in this kingdom is the kind of, is the way that women are discriminated against. You know, the king of Paurushpur, played by Anu Kapoor, who is the king's name is Bhadra Pratap, I think, if I'm getting it right. He is not he's not a very nice man. Okay, so he's, of course, he's very powerful, and you know, everybody has to listen to whatever he has to say. He loves women, but unfortunately, he likes to oppress them. So that is something that that kind of influences the way the whole kingdom looks at women and treats women. And there are people in the kingdom who don't like it, and now, you know, they want to change the way things are. So Boris is one of those people. And Boris, of course...
Interesting. So, speaking about your character, Milind, I have seen the promos, and I believe that you are playing a transgender warrior in the series by the name Boris. So who is Boris, and what's his story?
So Boris is a person who wants to fight injustice. He wants to fight against discrimination. And I think this comes to him naturally because as a eunuch, he has probably been fighting all his life to be recognized as a person, you know, to find his own space in society, you know, all of those things. And he realizes that, you know, even women are discriminated against, and women don't have their rightful place in society. So he wants to fight against discrimination. And it's like a lot of us, you know, until we face discrimination, we don't even realize how much discrimination there is in society. Because it's part of us, discrimination, you know, the way we judge people, the way we look at people, and we are afraid, you know, sometimes that they are different from us, and we don't know how to accept them, we don't know how to include them. So that kind of discrimination exists even today across many, many, many levels in society. Sometimes we don't even know that we're discriminating against people. So for him, it's more natural because he's a victim of discrimination his whole life. And he feels that he needs to stand up and do something about it.
Okay. This character is very different from the roles that you have played earlier. Did it take any special preparation? I mean, did you do any homework for this particular character?
No.
that's who you are. I mean, you don't
have to... I'd like to say, first, I'd like to say that every role that I have played, right from A Mouthful of Sky, which was in 1995, it was in India's first English series. All the roles that I have chosen to play have been different. And that's my whole, what drives me as an actor. And I think most actors is to do roles that are different to what they have played before. So each character is important. Each character is unique. And each character can be as challenging as you want. You know, obviously, there are a million ways to play any character. So it's up to you how much effort you want to put into it, how different you want to make it, how unique you want to make that character. So with Boris, it was a little bit easier because we didn't want to follow any stereotypes that exist or that we have seen, especially representations of eunuchs in Indian movies and on Indian television before this. Mostly, you know, they are represented as being very loud, their particular kind of costume, a particular way of speaking, a particular voice. So that kind of stereotyping and typecasting we wanted to avoid as far as possible and focus more on the human aspect of Boris. So Boris is a whimsical character. He dresses the way he wants, which is different from other people. But he is a person who has certain dreams and certain ambitions and certain beliefs. And that is what we've focused on more, you know, rather than, this is a transgender, this is a eunuch.
Sounds good. And Milind, you have been very particular and very, you know, specific about the kind of roles and projects you have chosen in your entire career. So what is your process of selecting and what kind of things excite you at this stage?
Well, as an actor, you have to be particular, you know, because what happens, and not only in India, but everywhere in the world, the moment an actor plays a role that is accepted by the audience, he starts getting offers to play roles which are exactly similar to the character that he played. You know, for an actor, that is something really terrible. So to break out of your image is the biggest challenge. So a lot of people would say to me when I posted the first picture of Boris, which was just my eyes and up till here, a very tight close-up, and I was wearing a nose pin, and I was wearing kajal, and my face was red with gulal. I posted this on Instagram, and a lot of people said, "Oh, you know, we want to see you as masculine, and we like this macho aspect of Milind Soman. Where is that? And this is effeminate, and this is not nice, and we don't like it." But then when they saw the trailers and they saw some snippets of the scenes, and you know, the character was a little bit more clear, then everybody, like 99% of the people who saw it, were like, "Wow, this is very interesting. This is great. We want to see more of it," and all of that. So for an actor, you have to be able to say it's okay that I have a certain image. Of course, there's an audience that liked me in a certain way. But as an actor, I have to experiment. As an actor, I must do different characters. Otherwise, I'm just not an actor anymore. I'm just a famous person in a movie, you know? Mm-hmm. And a lot of actors, the more popular you get, the more you get stuck in that image. Because you have a bigger fan base that loves you as a certain character. So as an actor, you have to continually try to break that. And as you grow more and more popular, it gets more and more difficult. And we see that with popular actors all over the world and even in India. They're just playing the same thing again and again and again because they're so scared. They feel ki hamare jo audience hai, hamare jo fans hai, wo humko accept nahi karegi. But for an actor, those considerations should not matter. Because first, you're an actor, not a famous person. You're an actor. Right?
Yeah. Right. Sounds great. So, Milind, coming to another thing, that you are an inspiration for those who do or at least try to maintain an active and, you know, healthy lifestyle. What has been your fitness routine during the period of social isolation?
So when the lockdown was first announced in March and suddenly everybody had to stay at home 24/7, it was a little difficult because I was used to traveling almost 20 days a month. Not even be able to go out on the roads because I like to run on the road. I like to run on the highway. I do a lot of long distance running whenever I have the time. So it was disturbing, very, very disturbing. And then after about a week, we started, in fact, everybody, my mother, my wife, me, we started running up and down the stairs in the building, you know, because we had to do something. And apart from that, it was okay, because I don't usually go to the gym at all. I don't like machines and I don't need weights. I like to work with my own body. So I always exercise at home anyway. So I just kept that exercise on. And I don't exercise much. I exercise 15, 20 minutes a day. So it was not like a big thing that was, you know, I had to create a new system, nothing like that. I kept that 15, 20 minutes, half an hour. Then I had more time, so I would do more, 45 minutes maybe in a day, but do a lot of running up and down the stairs. That was what I was doing.
Great.
And we saw lockdown ended, which was around, I think, March, April, by May. And then they were allowing you to, I think, go out a little bit, go out of the city. And then we started traveling almost immediately, and then just traveling more and more as it opened up. More and more. In fact, I went to the US as well. I've been traveling all over the country. I went to Darjeeling. We just came back from a trek, a 50 kilometer trek in West Bengal. So we've been trying to do as much as we can, even though there are restrictions.
Right, right. In fact, we saw some of the images lately, you running on a beach, and those images kind of raised a couple of eyebrows. But, you know, this is something that I don't think I would ever be able to. In fact, I think that will be something I would never be able to try by myself. So I just wanted to know, what is the experience like? How does it feel? I know that you love outdoors. As you mentioned, you love to, you know, run on streets and in outdoors activities you have been involved. What was that experience?
Well, if it was up to me, if it was comfortable for me, I would run naked everywhere. But, you know, it's not. So I was just trying to create maybe another image, because you said whenever we look at you, we see you coming out of a box. Now, maybe you have another image that you can think of.
It helps to break that image. Yeah, it has been replaced by a new image. And we'd love to see you running no matter what.
Thank you.
Okay, Milind, so... on another point, that these have been very testing times for the performing artists last few months. As like any other industry, entertainment industry too has been badly impacted by the pandemic. And on our platform, Talentrack, where we have currently 4 lakh plus artists registered with us, a large number of people are actors, models, and all that. What message would you like to give to those thousands of talented artists who are at this stage kind of anxious about their career in Bollywood? They don't know that how things are going to pan out.
Well, I don't know what to say, because this year has been difficult for everyone, not just actors. There are lots of people who have lost their jobs, a lot of people whose businesses have shut down. I mean, one of my offices, we had 65 people before the lockdown in that office. Now there are only 15 people. Because there are some businesses that that cannot function during a time like this. Like I'm an event manager. Okay, I've been an event manager for more than 30 years. We do a lot of events, but where travel is not allowed and people gathering is not allowed, how can you do events? So now we've of course shifted a lot into digital and online events and stuff like that. So I think for everybody, it is a time to introspect and a time to think and reinvent yourself. And really adapt in a way to this situation that is good for you. One thing I can say is that you cannot give up. You have to keep working hard. You have to keep thinking about what you can do. Because all of us are not just about one thing. You know, we all have different talents. Maybe we don't know. And maybe this is the time for us to find that talent, find out that interest, find out what it is with which we can create a new life.
Right. And... in the end, I would like to also know about your Pinkathon initiative. Where did the idea come from, and what has been the inspiration behind it?
Well, the idea for Pinkathon, like I was just saying, I'm an event manager, you know. So for me, it was, again, quite easy to create that space. And what happened was, as a marathon runner, I saw that marathon running was becoming really popular in our country. And in a country that has no tradition of sports or fitness or exercise or running. In fact, when I started running about 20 years ago, people used to think, ye kon pagal hai, and all that. And they still do. Non-runners, when they look at runners, they say, ye kya pagalpan hai? But I saw at that time that it was getting really popular, but the participation of women in running events was very small. It was like 4% or 5%. Mm-hmm. And there were many reasons that we could imagine, for that. But I thought that if we create a space that is exclusively for women, maybe we will address a lot of that reluctance, a lot of those obstacles that women might have in the mind saying, how can I be part of this? So we organized the first Pinkathon in 2012. It was a huge success. And today it's, almost a quarter of a million women have run in Pinkathon. We had probably the biggest running event globally this year on the 1st of November during the lockdown, where almost 20,000 participants, almost 20,000 women ran, but in different locations on the same day, on the 1st of November, which we call Pinkathon Day. It was this year, the third edition of Pinkathon Day, the third year, and we had almost 20,000 participants. So the community has become that strong of women who believe that they need to focus on their health. They need to take out some time during the day to focus on their physical, mental, and emotional well-being, even if it's 5 minutes. That community has become strong. They are now inspiring more and more women to just say, understand that even if you want to give 100% to your family and your children and your job and everybody else, you need to be 100% for that. So to be 100%, you need to spend some time with yourself. So that has been the message of Pinkathon. Not really about running and, 100 kilometers and stuff like that. It's about valuing yourself, respecting yourself, spending time with yourself for your own physical, mental, and emotional well-being.
Right. Milind, apart from Paurushpur, what are the other projects that you are currently doing and what we can hope to see from your side in coming months?
Well, that's a surprise. First is Paurushpur. I think a lot of people, whoever has seen the trailers, the response has been really fantastic. It's been very positive. This is probably the first medieval fantasy in that genre we have for Indian OTT. So people are really anticipating and people really want to see this first season. So I think, let me not spoil their anticipation by telling them what else I'm doing. I'm also really looking forward to seeing the first season, which is going to be released on the 29th of December, and with as much anticipation as everybody else.
Right. We all are, very eagerly looking forward to that. And for the kind of body of work you have, Milind, spanning decades of career, even an entire day is not enough to talk about it. So thank you. Thank you for joining us today for this lovely conversation. I really enjoyed it. And I wish you all the best for Paurushpur.
Thank you. Please watch it. And please give us your feedback. Tell us what you liked, what you didn't like. You have my number. You can even send me a message and let me know your response.
Definitely. In fact, we are also in our magazine. We are going to review it and I will send you the link as soon as our review is published.
Please do. Thank you so much.
So guys, this was Milind Soman. Stay tuned for more such interactions with your favorite stars. We will be back soon. Till then, stay safe.